Hi guys, I'm Mondo Guerra, a local-based fashion designer here in Denver, Colorado, and also winner of Project Runway All-Stars. And I am speaking to you today from my humble studio. I introduced myself into DCAP. I mean, I've lived here all my life. I grew up in Arvada, now I live in Denver. And when I was diagnosed with HIV in 2002, I was in New York, and I really couldn't support myself at that point, so I came back, and I lived with my family for the past 10 years. Colorado AIDS Project really helped me get to the point where I am right now. Without them really steering me in the right direction, I don't think I would have had the courage or the support to really make these goals, you know, a reality. To get on the show and achieve so much is really due to Colorado AIDS Project helping me get out of such a dark place and kind of start moving forward. And you know, being HIV positive, I think, you know, all of our stories are different. Everybody's story is unique, and this journey is going to be different. And for me, unfortunately, like I said, I had to hit rock bottom. But you know, Colorado AIDS Project is always there to support anybody and really listen to what their story is and really kind of gauge what each client needs to really move forward like I did. I went to them for their counseling services, and also when I wasn't able to support myself, I utilized their food bank. Again, I think, you know, everybody's story is a little different. You know, there can be so many different situations. Maybe they're intimidated to go into an office, and because of the stigma, they might think that person sitting next to them is HIV positive, and maybe that person, you know, we're in the community, but that's the strength about it. You know, Colorado AIDS Project is a local AIDS service organization, and the community really has to support it so it can grow and really help all these different people that are living with HIV to really be steered in the right direction. I'll be traveling to New York for World AIDS Day this year to do a social media tour with my campaign called iDesign in collaboration with Merck. And iDesign is a campaign that really empowers people living with HIV to really kind of take a tailored approach to their treatment. And we really want encourage, you know, people living with HIV to have this conversation with their doctor, because from my own personal story, I've learned that having that relationship with your doctor really empowers you to really make the right choices in your treatment plan. Everybody having this information and really knowing what HIV is and how not only it affects, might affect somebody physically, but how it affects somebody emotionally. And, you know, just, again, having that conversation with somebody that you might know that's affected by the disease and getting that information. Being recognized as a advocate for HIV AIDS, people always ask me what they can do to help. And I always tell them, the best thing that you want to do, A, is know your own status. B, have this conversation with somebody that you don't think accesses this information. Or maybe somebody that you know might be intimidated to talk about it. They're the ones that really need to know and start talking about this. We all need to have this conversation. And third, I think one of the smartest things to do as a community to see Colorado AIDS Project grow, Denver Colorado AIDS Project grow, go out there and volunteer. Even if it's for 4 hours a week, 2 hours a week, they can always use help. So go out and volunteer. Go work in the food bank or donate food or whatever you can do to help that your neighbor, your friend, your brother, your aunt, whoever it is. We're all affected by this. We might not all be infected by HIV, but we're all affected by HIV. We all have this idea of stigma and how it affects any disease for that matter. But in this case, it is a very negative approach to move forward. You know, there are so many different myths that could be applied to being HIV positive, and again, I think it's different for everybody. Let's not focus on the negative, let's focus on the positive and continue to move forward. It's not about the myths, it's not about who says what, or people think this, think that. It's really about not letting this disease define who we are as people, and having the conversation and moving forward. Red Ball is such a wonderful event. You know, we are dealing with a very important issue and a very important day. But, you know, the event is so much fun. There's a silent auction, and you get to see some really great fashion, and all these creative people in the community come together to put on a really great show, and I think everybody's really pumped up for it, so...
Oh, got that one. I think we got it.
Yeah.